Damn, why these vids gotta be 18 minutes long? Oh, my bad. It's your boy Juby, and we back with a banger, you feel me? So we've been reacting to a lot of AI lately, you feel me? So we're gonna see what it's all about, though. You know, we need a little introduction. AI songs explained. You hear me?
On the 15th of April, a TikTok user by the name of Ghostwriter977 posted this song onto the platform. The song, which was titled Heart on My Sleeve, was the long-awaited new collaboration between Drake and The Weeknd. The only problem? The song was created entirely through the use of artificial intelligence, or AI, software. Within days, Drake's record label was scrambling to burn all traces of the song's existence, but it was too late, as it had already spread like wildfire, racking up millions of views across both TikTok and YouTube. Perhaps the most interesting part of this whole debacle, though, is that this AI-generated song was seemingly better received by fans than the real Drake's latest single, Search and Rescue. This raises the question, will AI begin to replace artists in the coming years? Before I answer that question, though, if you're a fan of human-made content, make sure you subscribe to my channel. And if you haven't skipped this part just yet, maybe drop a like as well. Thank you. Now, on with the video. To understand the problems surrounding AI music, we first need to look at what machine learning actually is, and how it works. Over the last few months, you've probably seen these AI-generated song covers pop up in your YouTube recommendations. Kendrick rapping Touch the Sky, Kanye singing Day and Night, Joe Biden rapping Boy's a Liar. Truthfully, the quality is kinda all over the place. I mean, some of them are really dodgy, but others are actually pretty convincing. And it's hard to believe this isn't the real artist's voice. Typically, the best ones involve artists with similar vocal ranges and accents. Like, if you want Future to cover an Ariana Grande song, it's probably gonna turn out sounding like poop. To create an AI cover, you need to start with an artificial voice. Say you wanted to make Kendrick rap Orange Soda by Baby Keem, you would need to find an AI to mimic Kendrick's voice. To do this, you would have to find at least 100 5-to-10-second audio snippets of Kendrick rapping, and then put them all in a folder. This is what's called a dataset, and the AI will use all of this input to hopefully create a convincing fake voice. Once you have your dataset ready, you'll drag it into a program that will create your AI model. One of the more popular of these is Google Collab, which will train the model for free. However, there are other paid versions which are more effective.
$2,000 likes in this bid, right? And I'll make an AI. Cover song. Just give me 2,000 likes, that's all I need.
It'll take a while to load, but once it's done, you can move on to the next step. Here is where we'll bring in the Baby Keem side of the equation. You can drag in the Orange Soda a cappella, or you could just rap the song yourself and use that. You'll simply replace your vocals with the trained AI voice. Right there, you'll have your Kendrick cover. Then you'll mix the Kendrick a cappella vocals over the Orange Soda instrumental, and voila, you're done. What's amazing and terrifying about this is anyone can do it. Even I could pick it up pretty quickly, and I have next to no prior knowledge about how AI works. As far as we know, artificial intelligence has yet to create a convincing song in the style of a human artist without human interference. Going back to that fake Drake song, we actually don't know how much of that song was generated by an AI. Was it just the vocals, or also the lyrics? What about the beat? My guess would be that Ghostwriter977 made the beat, or bought it from somewhere, wrote the lyrics, and then recorded reference vocals before replacing those vocals with the AI models of Drake and The Weeknd. The lyrics could have been written by a lyric generator, but either way, a human had to be at least somewhat involved to make that song. In theory, an artificial intelligence could listen to every song ever made within minutes, something we can never do even if we live for hundreds of years. This makes it a very powerful tool, with many implications to either help or harm artists. This has sparked a-
Hey, that's why they say AI is scary, cause real talk? Imagine in the future, AI music is all over, you feel me? And it's the new thing. You artists now will not last. I'm telling you, it's scary, it's very, very scary.
The debate over how AI music should be regulated. Where some think that AI is unethical and will lead to real musicians losing their jobs, others hold the view that AI will actually make life easier for artists and open up new possibilities. So here...
It's going to make it easier for them, though. It's at the same time too easy for them. And then the old head's going to be like, bro, y'all have it easy back in my day. And things of that nature. And that's going to be crazy. Just watch. And when I say old heads, I'm going to be talking about me. Because I'm going to be an old head around that time. But, you know, at the same time, though, things are moving quickly. So it could happen in minutes. If you know, you know.
Gonna break down the first side of the debate and give the argument as to why AI is an existential threat to the music industry. As I alluded to in the intro, the release of that fake Drake and Weeknd song sparked Universal Music Group to try and erase it from the internet due to concerns about monetization. It's kind of like if you uploaded a full Taylor Swift song to YouTube. The record label would copyright claim it in like 2 seconds and then collect any advertising revenue it made. However, in many ways, the concern with this fake song is more complicated than that. UMG has flagged how the song was created using an AI model that was trained through using copyrighted material. Essentially, to create those fake Drake and Weeknd voices, the AI would have used tons of songs that fall under copyright. Throughout April, UMG sent letters to streaming services like Apple Music and Spotify to remove AI-generated songs, as well as requesting that AI services be banned entirely from training AI models on copyrighted content. This action speaks to a worry held not only by huge corporations, but artists across the board. The idea that AI models will be trained using already existing songs without the original artists getting a cut of the profits. Whilst UMG has made a big splash in its reaction to these AI-generated songs, it's possible that its efforts to restrict the use of AI may be futile. In an article published by CNN Business, entertainment attorney Carl Falk said this, "I understand the intent behind the move, but I'm not sure how effective this will be, as AI services will likely still be able to access the copyrighted material one way or another." Like piracy, it seems like AI-generated music is something that the industry is going to have to adapt to rather than completely flush out.
It could either get worse or better. That's all I could say. I don't know. I feel like the government might come and do something about this. What y'all think? They might feel some type of way about this, because you're hearing about the copyright and all that. You know, that's serious. Something might happen, though. Y'all tell me down below how you feel.
That said, there are serious questions to be addressed about who owns music made by an AI. Is it the person who created the AI program, the artist the AI was trained with, the person who used the program, or the machine itself? Whilst in the case of the fake Drake song, it's pretty obvious what the model was trained with, for other songs made through machine learning, it may not be as clear. This means that hit songs could be made through minimal effort, putting artists who have put years of work into their craft at risk of being put out of business or losing their creative drive. Perhaps huge artists like Drake and The Weeknd will be able to avoid being hurt by this. But what about smaller and up-and-coming artists? Already apps like Endel have the capability to artificially generate background music. So what does that mean for human creators who compose music for podcasts and videos? As far as we know, AI can't create new genres of music or new forms of art just yet. For example, if you go to an AI art generator, even the best ones won't be able to come up with something that doesn't fit into an art style humans have already created. In January this year, a man from New Zealand asked ChatGPT to write song lyrics in the style of Australian songwriter Nick Cave. Cave actually ended up responding to the lyrics, disregarding them as a grotesque mockery of what it is to be human. And yeah, those lyrics were cringy at best. But what Cave is getting at here is that art made by artificial intelligence, in his eyes, will always be of lesser value than that made by human artists.
It's facts, because like, bro, creativity is going to be gone. I'm telling you. It's going to be gone. It's going to be out the window. All the hard work, like he said in the vid, all the hard work, people are trying to make it to the top. Yeah. What am I saying? All the people that are trying to make it to the top, it's not going to make it to the top because of AI. Or dumb people might use AI to make it to the top easily. That's tough.
even if they appear indistinguishable. That's certainly a moral viewpoint, but perhaps one that will be shared less and less as AI progresses. For argument's sake, let's say I had two songs, one with lyrics written entirely by a human artist, and the other with lyrics written by an artificial intelligence. If I asked you which one you'd rather listen to, I'm guessing you'd choose the one with the human-made lyrics. But what if you couldn't tell the difference between the two? What if you found out tomorrow that Steve Lacy wrote Bad Habit with the help of ChatGPT? How would that make you feel about that song? Is good music always good music, regardless of how it was made? That's a question that I think is going to become very relevant over the coming months and years, because AI platforms are becoming more sophisticated seemingly every day. Maybe right now AI-generated lyrics can't compare to ones written by human artists, but so far we've underestimated just how fast AI technology can develop. For example, this is what Oleg Stavitsky, who was the CEO of Endel, said about AI just 3 years ago in 2020. AI music is simply not good enough to create a song that you would listen to and be like, I would rather listen to this than Drake. But now only 3 years later, songs like Heart on My Sleeve exist.
With new Scope Squeeze Mouthwash Concentrate, add water, squeeze twice, or even three times.
And honestly, yeah, I would much rather listen to that than the real Drake's latest single. It's almost inevitable that there will soon be entire fan-made albums using AI voices. If Frank Ocean never drops another album, it's all good. Blonde 2 will be generated using an AI.
Hey,
to test just how convincing
tough.
These AI voices are, I decided to conduct a little experiment. Alright, so basically, I found 4 casual music listeners and asked them to listen to 3 original songs, and then 3 AI covers off those same songs. My hypothesis was that they wouldn't be able to tell the difference between the two. Let's see how it goes. Alright, so today we're going to be playing you some AI songs and some real songs, and you're going to have to choose which is the AI version. You ready?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. This is...
Hey, I should do that. Not even cap, I should do that. That's a good video idea. Comment down below.
This is version number 1.
Fashion week is more your thing than mine. Fashion week is more your thing than mine.
So which one is the AI version? 1 or 2?
1, I think.
1? Yep, you're right.
I wanted to go with 2. I don't know why. 2 just feels
it's
something.
Actually number 1.
Oh,
yeah.
Damn.
Okay, which one did you think was the AI version?
The first one, because I didn't pronunciate any of the words.
Yeah, you're right.
The second one's artificial.
So you reckon the second one's artificial?
Yeah. Yes.
You are wrong. The second one is the real version. Drake is the real version.
So what time is showing? At the same time, though, I feel like they got to know the artist, too, because, like, If I never listened to it to The Weeknd or Drake, and you showed me the same thing, I would just pick any of them, because how would I know? You feel me? Like, if they don't know the artist, then it's gonna be very, very hard.
About the world and about just who we really are. So I try to show her about the world and about just who we really are.
So 1 or 2, which is the AI version?
1, I think.
Really? That's the wrong one. Number 2 is the AI version. Damn. So which one is the AI version? 1 or 2?
1.
Wow, so number 2 is the AI version.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm not good at this.
Which one is the AI version? Number 1 or 2?
They literally sound the same to me. I think it's like the first one's the real one?
Yes, the first one's the real one.
Alright.
That's
least...
weird.
You know what? I'm going to stick with my guns. I'm going to have to go with 2.
The real one is actually number 1.
Ah, damn.
Yeah.
She think I'm a player, she keep running back though, only cause I pay her. She think I'm a player, she keep running back though, only cause I pay.
Oh my god, what is that?
1 or 2, AI?
2.
2, yep, you're right. Congrats, alright, you got
god,
2 out of 3.
Song.
So which one's the AI one, number 1 or number 2?
I reckon it's number 1 this time.
Come here. Come here. Yeah, you white boy.
Really? So just choose which is the AI version.
Okay.
1 or 2.
First one.
First one's the AI.
I don't know. Now you're like looking at me funny. I'm like,
yeah, the second one's the AI.
Bro, come on. You don't know the song Roxanne. Roxanne. Juby is the best all night.
You got all 3 wrong. Okay, which one is the AI version? 1 or 2?
2.
You're right. Fantastic. So you got all 3 correct.
Yeah.
Let's go.
So I think the results were pretty clear. On average, the people I talked to had a 42% accuracy rate at guessing the original version and the fake one, which supported my initial hypothesis. What are the implications of this though? Assuming that AI covers and deepfakes are legally permitted to continue being made, then they'll undoubtedly become even more convincing. This not only raises
Did Kendrick Lamar predict this or something? Y'all comment down below.
Questions about what artistry means, but also about identity theft and security at large. Focusing purely on the music though, I think the biggest threat to artists is listeners becoming indifferent to whether or not the real artists had a hand in creating something with their name and voice attached to it. That said, as of right now, listeners largely regard AI covers as fun gimmicks, and nothing more serious than that. Okay, so now that I've gone through the risks that AI presents to the music industry and artists, here I'm gonna argue the other side of the debate and explore why AI music may not be quite as scary as it seems on the surface. In truth, these fears about how AI will change the industry are kind of familiar. Similar debates are...
If you want that, okay, this, I'm gonna cut this video in one part and two parts, you feel me? If you want to know about how AI is not scary, please... comment down below. I got you. We're gonna go crazy, alright? But if not, please comment down below. Subscribe or I'll eat your fries. Real talk. Row 2, 1.65. Let's get it.